Hi, I'm Martine Friesen at the Manitoba Arts Council. I'm a program consultant here. So welcome to the first of three tutorials. Today, we're going to walk you through how to create a profile on MAC's online application system.
So the first step in applying for a grant at MAC is to log into our online application system. And how you do that is you go to the MAC website at artscouncil.mb.ca and you click in the sign in button on the top right hand screen there. And ta-da, that takes you to our online application system. And you scroll down a little bit to the register button and you click on that, and that will get you started in the system. So there's three ways of entering our system, either as an applicant or a nominator, the nominator, or the assessor. Today we're going to be an applicant, so we're going to click on that. There we go. Okay, so there are three different applicant types. You can either be an individual, and there's lots of subtypes within that. You can be a group, or you can be an organization, and again, there's lots of subtypes within that. Today we're going to be an individual, so let's click on that. And that takes you to the eligibility quiz. Now, I'm going to just point out one thing before we start that. There's lots of links along the way that are really useful. I highly recommend that you click on them. In this case, we have MAC's General Guidelines, which is a really global document, which has lots of useful information. So I recommend that you check that out if you haven't already. So let's select what kind of individual applicant we are. There's four choices to choose from: professional artist, arts cultural professional, student of the arts, and Indigenous knowledge keeper. Today we're going to be a professional artist, and that takes you to a series of yes-no questions, and you have to answer all the questions that have an asterisk. If you don't provide an answer, then you will not be able to submit your profile. So just make sure you pay attention to those little red marks. So am I a professional artist? I am. Am I a Canadian citizen? Yes. Am I a resident of Manitoba? Yep, you have to be if you want to access funding at MAC. Yes. I'm 18 years of age or older. Yes. I have training. Yes. Oops, just going to scroll down a little bit further. I am recognized by my peers as a professional artist. Yes, I can commit a significant amount of time. And I have a history of professional public presentation or publication. Oops, yes, you have to acknowledge that the information is correct. And you acknowledge that your profile must be approved by MAC staff. So you click submit. Excellent, you got through that. So the actual registration is in two parts. First part is some contact information, and then there's some voluntary identification information. Again, here's another one of those useful links that tells you about MAC's policy on the use of personal information, because you're going to be inputting some of that here. So your first name, I'm going to be Mary today, and my last name is going to be Smith. You can put in a middle name or not. Professional name, that's if you have a professional name that you work under. Your address, I'm going to have 222 Main Street. Oops. As you can see, I'm not a very good typer. City or town, I'm going to be living in Flin Flon. Province, Manitoba, postal code, RRR222, primary email. Now, this is important. This is going to be your username, and it should be the email address that you use most often. So Mary is going to have this as her MacTutorial000@gmail.com. I'm going to have a phone number, 204-999-9999. Now you have to check off which artistic discipline is most applicable to you. So only check off the ones in which you are recognized as a professional artist in which you work in. So Mary is going to be a musical person. She's going to be a world music fiddle player. And she does ethnocultural folk music as well, and she plays a little percussion. Okay, so here we reach the voluntary identification section, which is just that, voluntary. But we would appreciate it if you filled it out because it allows us to just track how well we're serving the full diversity of this province. So select your language, primary language. Mary's primary language is English. Mary, I speak, read, and understand English. So I'm going to check that off. And Mary also went to, we're going to say she went to French immersion. So she does have some French. She speaks it. And she can read, she can speak it a little bit. So she's going to click off there. Birth date, 1982. Gender, female. If she's not Indigenous, but if you were, you could click off there. Francophone, visible minority. We have some accessibility plan and policy information here for you to click on. Again, you have to declare that the information you provided is correct. And then this link will take you to max terms and conditions. This link will take you to information about how you interface with our online application system. So please read that, click on that, and submit. If you missed anything, an error message will come up, but we didn't miss anything, so we're good. So now what we have to do is we've submitted the first part of the profile. So now we have to upload an artistic resume or CV for review. This is going to be something that will be shared with all the assessors for any application that you submit. So you should keep it up to date. So we need to do that. So now what we do is we go to our email address. We will have received an email. Oh, there it is. And it will come from Helpdesk. So let's open this up and take a look at what it says. Dear Mary, congratulations. You have completed the first part of your profile. We have our username, of course, which is MacTutorial@000. And then we're given a temporary password. To complete the registration of your profile, please go to the website and upload the current CV or artistic resume. Once you have submitted your completed profile, MacStaff will review it within 15 business days. So that's after you've submitted and uploaded your resume. So I'm going to copy my temporary password here. And then I'm going to go here into there. That takes me back into the login. So I'm going to put my password in and my email. If you remember, it's my username is my email address. Okay. And then we log in. Da, 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 da. Now, I highly recommend you change your password at this time. So we're going to change our password. Our current password is that. And my new password is going to be none of your business. Keep your password to yourself. Okay. And now we're going to hit submit. Uh-oh, new password did not match. Okay, let's try this again. New password. Sometimes these things happen, right? This is just our modern world. Okay, let's see. Hopefully that works. Yay, it was successful. Okay, so now I go back to, I go scroll back. Okay, refresh. And I'm going to go to my personal profile. Okay, there's my information. Excellent. 222 Main Street, Flin Flon, Mary Smith. Okay, and now this is where I'm going to upload my CV. So you click on this. No files have been selected. I can put, it can either be PDF or a Word document right here. So now we're going to click on this. And it's going to allow me to browse my computer. There it is, artistic resume. And there it is, it's done, upload is complete. And we can see it, fantastic, we'll click out. And there it is. So now you you can save draft. Always save, and now we're going to make sure it's still there. Yeah, we can see it. There it is. And we're going to submit. Excellent. So the profile is submitted. So you're good. Now MAC staff needs 15 business days approximately to review it, and then you can start applying for grants. Thanks for watching.
So that's all you need to know to create a profile on MAC's online application system. If you need any assistance at any time throughout the process, please contact Helpdesk. You can call them at 204-945-2237 or toll free at 1-866-994-2787. You can also email them at helpdesk@artscouncil.mb.ca. Thanks for watching. Bye.